This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. I'm joined by the lead scientist for the Nature Conservancy, M. Sanjayan, who's stopping by on a trip to a very far off place. We're talking about the Thelen River watershed. First of all, where is this?
So Thelen River is this amazing river that flows into the largest game reserve, essentially in North America. The area is bigger than Yellowstone and Glacier and the Serengeti combined. And it sits right between Northwest Territories of Canada and Nunavut, which is another territory, just below the Arctic Circle, and it's tundra. So it's all low, barren country of sedges, mosses, and mosquitoes.
And you're going to go there with a half dozen teenagers as well.
Right.
Why?
So the whole land traditionally belonged to the Dene First Nation people. The Dene are an indigenous community that lived there and has been living there for millennia. And the Thelen is considered to be the place where God began his work for them. It's got lots of spiritual meaning. It's their hunting grounds. It's the place they got all their sustenance from. But over time, as modern civilization, Western civilization has intruded upon their lives, that connection has been lost. And we think the Dene are great voices for the conservation of that region. It is their land after all. And we want to bring that back by taking some of their youth into this huge country.
And you're a scientist. What are you hoping to study?
Well, there's caribou up there. And they're moose, they're grizzly bears, they're barren ground grizzlies, which are grizzlies that tend to be more hungry than normal because they're living in open country and looking for food all the time. There's musk ox. So, and this time of year, there will be tens of thousands of migratory birds. So basically all the birds from South America and the U.S. head up there and breed up there. Ducks, waterfowl, songbirds, because there's a profusion of insects and water. Mm-hmm. And so wildlife-wise, this place is going to be amazing. But for me, the big challenge about this trip and the big opportunity about this trip is to really understand the land through the eyes of the Dene. Mm-hmm. And that is a rare thing to find in North America anymore.
So how are you even going to get there? It's going to take you several flights to even get close, and then you have to take smaller planes, and then what?
Yeah, so the planes get getting smaller and smaller and creakier and creakier. The last one is called, I think it's called the Suicide Tube by the locals who fly it. But basically, you fly to Calgary, then you go to Yellowknife, and then from there, it's two charter planes that gets us into the country. The distance is so far that one of the planes essentially has to go and drop fuel out there in order for the plane to refuel, like basically throw fuel drums on the side of a lake. The plane lands in the lake, you can refuel and continue on. So you really are going, if you look at a map of North America and you throw a dart at the biggest open spot on the continent, it's going to be the Thelen.
Okay, and these kids and everybody is going to be packing all of their stuff in. It's almost about 100 pounds a person, which is a lot, including canoes.
Yeah. I think it'll end up being a little bit more than 100 to when we start and less than that as we food up as we go along. Hopefully just the food. But yeah, we're going to have packable canoes. We'll have about 100 pounds plus per person. It's about 3,800 pounds in total. And there is a spot on the river where we know already, just from looking at maps, that we'll probably have to carry everything for about 4 miles. So that's the part that I'm a little bit unsure of. Mm-hmm. How I'm going to hold up, how my team members are going to hold up, how the kids are going to hold up.
Okay, well, let's take a look at some of your gear.
Well, I brought you a few things that we carry with us.
Okay.
It's just a small sample of some of the key things that I carry on this trip, but frankly, I take on most trips I go on. So first of all, this thing, which is my personal flotation device, as they call it.
Right.
And that's the most important thing, really, because you're going to be on canoes the whole time.
Sure.
The other really important thing that I could not leave home without is a bug suit.
And so is everybody going to be wearing these?
How
bad are the bugs there?
They're bad. They're bad enough that the only reason caribou stop moving to feed is, I mean, they'll stop and feed, and then they'll start running again because the bugs will chase them.
Wow.
So for caribou, it's a constant battle between moving and eating. If the bugs weren't there, the caribou would just denude the land. It's the bugs that keep the caribou moving. I mean, it's that bad. It's kind of the reason why they migrate. It's not because they run out of food. It's because they're running
they're
away from bugs.
They're chased by mosquitoes.
Yeah, that's actually kind of real. And bear spray. So everyone will carry this. You know, you've got grizzly bears are a real challenge.
Yeah.
And you know, it's open country, so you should be able to see them. But the amazing thing about grizzlies is you never see them until it's too late.
Wow.
And so you do want to be aware. We have a couple of rifles with us as well, because we will have to feed ourselves sometimes on caribou if we get lucky.
Okay.
Otherwise, not much protein. But the other thing to feed ourselves with is to catch fish.
Yeah.
And there's northern pike up there.
These are huge, huge
right.
flies.
So flies that look like mice.
Okay.
And solar panels to power everything, power our GPSs, our cameras, our laptops.
And this doesn't weigh that much either.
No, and Goal Zero Elite makes these amazing cameras with amazing batteries, quite light. And they really do work in the field. And so I'm a huge fan.
So you basically just plug directly in and then you're charging your laptops or whatever else.
Exactly. Okay. And because we have like 18 hours of life light up there, we're good. You know, little hero cameras on the canoes to get really cool point of view shots.
And all your kids are going to have similar types of gear,
bits and pieces? Yeah, little bits and pieces of this. Certainly the bug spray, certainly the bug suit, the PDFs, things like that. But everyone will be involved in this, so everyone will carry similar stuff.
And we can follow your trip for these 20 days. How?
You can follow it on nature.org. So if you go to nature.org, it's really easy. You'll find a link to the Thelon expedition. Or you can follow it, hopefully, on PBS.
All right. This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.